Hello everyone, and welcome to my first official tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a child theme for any theme. In this tutorial, I will create a child theme of 2017 theme, which is currently latest theme of WordPress. So if I log into my admin panel, I can show you in my appearance themes that currently I have activated 2017 theme. Here is 2017 theme. I just activated it. So I can show you its preview. This is how it looks. To create a child theme, first open your favorite text editor. In this, I'm going to use Sublime Text 3. This is my all-time favorite text editor. So you can use your own, like on Windows, you can use Notepad++, or even you can find Sublime Text for your Windows operating system or Linux operating system. So open this and create. First of all, we need to create a folder in our WordPress installation themes folder. So just log into your browse to your WP content themes folder and create a new folder. Rename it 2017 child. So I just name it 2017 child and I copy style.css and functions.php file along with screenshot, copy three items and I will paste it inside this 2017 child. Then I will drag and drop it on the side panel of Sublime Text. Click on style.css. Remove everything beneath the comments section. So here it is saying, and so following changes we need to make. First, theme name is 2017 child. So to make sure that this is a 2017 child, let them as it is be as it is. Just add an extra element attribute template 2017. So this one will be a 2017 text domain. So I will just copy it as it is and here I will put 2017 child text domain. Rest you can delete or you can leave it as it is. After that I will save this file and go to functions.php. Remove everything from it as we are not going to override everything. So just remove and keep that PHP sign only. Save it. Now go to your appearance themes. If everything goes well, you will see a 2017 child theme. And here it is, it's saying 2017 child, the same title which you have given in style here. So I will just activate this one and you will see it will lose all the look and feel of what you have seen here. Just I will right click and open a new tab and you see you have lost all the settings and everything. So why this happened? Because child theme have not loaded the style sheet of its parent, as well as it doesn't have its own style.css. So it's using default WordPress styling to show current status of the page. So what I'm going to do is just log into, open the Sublime Text editor, open function.php. Here I will add two scripts in add action. Add action. So it asks me first the tag, which tag and which function I need to add. So tag is wp enqueue scripts. This is our tag. Then what WordPress will enqueue scripts, then run the following function. Which function? Wp enqueue child parent styles. So then we will create a function with same name, and so first we will enqueue the parent, then we will enqueue the child, so it will keep the inheritance. Anything we make, any changes, if we are making any changes in style.css of child, if we are loading it before parent, it will not override the changes. So wp enqueue script or style, enqueue style. Here we need to put the handle. So first it's handle which we will use for dependency is parent style sheet, and in the false section we are going to put get template directory URI, template directory URI dot slash style dot css. For these other parameters we can remove them, as in style we don't really need those. And after that we save it again. Now we will enqueue style again. This time I will mention child style sheet. So in false, as previously I used get template directory, it will see what template I'm using here and it will get that path. So here that's why I use get template directory URI. In the child theme, get style sheet directory URI I will use, and then style.css. So this will get style sheet directory will get the current directory, current what you call it, current active themes directory. So from that it will load this style of this. And an array here I will mention that it is dependent on parent style sheet, so it should load after. So first must be loaded parent style sheet, then it will load the child theme. That's I make it in this dependency. So false and all we don't need, so just remove it. After that save it, and then if we go and refresh our page in the app, all everything if goes good, it will be back to this look and feel. So just refresh this page. Oh, sorry, there is some mistake in the function.php line 5. So sorry, this one is mistaken. This again I will reload, sorry for that. And now you see everything is same as it looks here. Everything, you see. So this is how you easily and quickly create a child theme and enqueue the style sheets of parent and child. This is the way. There is another way that you can copy all the CSS from style.css of parent and then paste it here. After that, we don't need to enqueue parent. We can continue with the child thing, but I don't recommend this. I prefer to do it this way. So this is how we create the child theme of any of the WordPress themes. Okay, I hope you like this video. Thank you for watching this tutorial.